Dear participants, first of all, I would like to thank the organizers of the conference who at this difficult time decided not to postpone and to hold the conference, and especially the chair of the conference, Professor Christos Skiadas. The title of my presentation is The Theory of Hidden Oscillations, and the lecture is dedicated to the memory of an outstanding scientist, Professor Gennady Leonov. Gennady Leonov passed away in 2019. He was a member of the honorary committee and scientific advisors of the House conferences. Gennady Leonov obtained a number of important results in nonlinear dynamics, which will be discussed in my presentation. In my lecture, I will recall the history of both of the theories of stability and oscillations, and tell about your current stage of development associated with the theory of hidden oscillations, when I will demonstrate corresponding results for the Lorentz-like systems, and discuss hidden attractors in connection with some famous theoretical and engineering problems. During the lecture, I will discuss the stability and oscillations of dynamical models with continuous time and smooth or discontinuous right-hand side. The ideas on stability and oscillations in dynamical systems are traced back to Henri Poincaré. Your significant development is associated with the names of Ляпунов and Андронов. In 1892, Alexander Ляпунов published his monograph with the foundation of the stability theory. He suggested a rigorous definition of stability and elaborated a way to establish local stability of smooth dynamical models without integration of trajectories via the construction of the so-called Ляпунов functions. Almost 40 years later, Alexander Андронов combined the Ляпунов's ideas of stability and ideas of limit cycles introduced by Henri Poincaré and developed the mathematical theory of oscillations and bifurcations, which explained behavior of various applied dynamical models. It is interesting that a few years later, similar ideas were published by Yves Racard, the father of French atomic bomb. In the framework of the theory of oscillations, Андронов and his supervisors and colleagues described a stable stationary regime as a non-self-excited state. And the transition from the unstable stationary regime to a periodic oscillation was described as self-excitation of periodic oscillations. Remark that the famous book of Андронов, Theory of Oscillations, was devoted to two-dimensional systems only, and multidimensional models and chaotic behavior were not considered there. However, Андронов's ideas of self-excitation of oscillations turned out to be useful for the study of multidimensional model also. In general, the study of applied models starts with the analysis of equilibria and your local stability. If there is an unstable equilibrium, then one has to study behavior of trajectories in its vicinity to check the stability of the whole stationary set. See, for example, a pendulum with friction. There, the stationary set contains unstable equilibria, but the whole set is globally attractive. In the same way, one may review non-trivial attractors in the model, like periodic attractor in the van der Pol model or chaotic attractor in the classical Lorentz model. However, to check the global stability, one has to reveal all possible attractors in the system, not only those that are excited from the vicinity of unstable equilibria. In 2009, Gennady Leonov and me suggested the following classification of attractors. An attractor is called a self-excited attractor if its basin of attraction intersects with small neighborhood of an equilibrium. Otherwise, it is called a hidden attractor. For example, hidden attractors are attractors in the system without equilibria or with the only stable equilibrium, which is a special case of multistability. Was the Van der Poel attractor and Lorentz attractor are self-excited according to this definition. Now let us consider a well-known engineering problem that stimulated the development of the classical theories of Lyapunov and Andronov and the theory of hidden oscillation. It is the problem of analysis of stability and oscillation of a flying ball regulator. It is a classical control system which was invented by James Watt in 1788 and when widely used to maintain a constant rotation speed. However, it soon turned out that such a regulator doesn't always stabilize the system, and dangerous oscillations can occur. Once the scientists were tasked to identify the conditions for stable operation and explain the occurrence of oscillations in the system with such regulators. One of the first solutions of this problem was suggested by scientists from St. Petersburg, Ivan Vyshnegradsky, in 1877. That time, Alexander Lyapunov was a second-year student in St. Petersburg University. Vyshnegradsky derived a non-linear discontinuous dynamical model of the regulator, considered a linearized model without dry friction and obtain conditions of local stability. Based on engineering reasoning, he conjectured that this condition is sufficient for stable operation of the regulator. Later, his work was criticized by other famous scientists, Zhukovsky, who pointed out that linearization, especially for discontinuous systems, has to be justified and in general cannot be used for the study of non-local behavior. After that, Van der Poel, Krylov and Bogolyubov suggested the so-called harmonic balance method, which was the first effective method for the study of oscillations. While the harmonic balance method confirms the conjecture, it cannot be rigorously justified in this case and in general may give inaccurate results. Only in 1944, Andronov finally confirmed the Vyshnegradsky conjecture with the help of his theory of oscillations. Thus, finally, it was proved that linearization and conditions of local stability implies global stability and absence of hidden oscillations for the flying ball regulator. However, in general, local stability may not imply global stability. Consider a modification of classical Vyshnegradsky model for the flying ball regulator with servo motor. Here, Vyshnegradsky and Stadola by linear analysis obtained the following condition of local stability. Under these conditions, the harmonic balance method confirms the global stability. However, by numerical analysis, one may reveal hidden oscillations in the model, for example, for these parameters. Remark that Grigorius Andronov's analysis of global stability and oscillations occupied more than 40 pages, even for a three-dimensional case, and hardly can be repeated here for the considered four-dimensional model. Only in 1971 Gennady Leonov obtained sufficient conditions of global stability for this model via the Barbashin and Krasovsky approach. In this case, stability of linearized system doesn't imply global stability, and there is a gap between necessary and sufficient conditions. In 1952, Barbashin and Krasovsky generalized ideas of Lyapunov for the study of global stability and suggested a criteria of global stability based on using global Lyapunov functions. Later, these ideas were developed by LaSalle and others. This approach allows us to estimate in the space of parameters the domain corresponding to the global stability. The boundaries of global stability are determined by the depth of oscillations due to local bifurcations in the vicinity of the stationary set. Such parts of the boundary are trivial or non-local bifurcations. Such parts of the boundary are hidden. If an oscillation is born via such a non-local bifurcation of the loss of global stability, then it is a hidden oscillation, since the basin of its attraction is separated from the locally attractive stationary set. The revealing of hidden oscillations and obtaining initial data for real computation are challenging problems. Now let us consider corresponding results on stability and the depth of oscillations in the Lorentz-like model. The construction of global Lyapunov functions for the Lorentz-like models is a challenging problem. Therefore, various attempts were made to use linearization for the study of global stability of the Lorentz-like models, as it was done for the flying ball regulators. The difficulties on this way can be demonstrated by the famous Marcus Yamabe conjecture and corresponding counterexamples, where the linearized model is stable at any point of the phase space, but still there exists a hidden oscillation, a trajectory not tending to the unique equilibrium zero point. However, in 1991, Gennady Leonov, developing the ideas of Krasovsky, obtained an effective criterion of global stability on this way. His criterion, together with the Barbashin, Krasovsky, and LaSalle theorems, allow us to obtain the following inner estimation of the global stability domain in the phase space of parameters for the Lorentz system. Here, in the case of one equilibrium point, we use Barbashin-Krasovsky theorem, and for the case of three equilibrium points, we have to apply LaSalle theorem and Leonov's criterion. Outside of the obtained inner estimation of the global stability domain, the depth of self-excited and hidden oscillations can be studied numerically in the bounded region of the phase space, since the Lorentz model is dissipative in the sense of Levinson and has an absorbing set. From a practical point of view, only the birth of non-trivial attractors is of interest. An upper estimation of the global stability domain can be obtained by the condition of instability of all equilibrium states, when it is obvious that the system has a non-trivial character because of its dissipativity. This is the case of the classical Lorentz attractor, which is self-excited with respect to all three equilibria. However, by reducing parameter R, the attractor can be disconnected from symmetric equilibria, In this case, it is self-excited only with respect to zero equilibrium, and the system is multistable. The open question is where it is possible to disconnect the attractor and the Lorentz system from all equilibria to get a hidden Lorentz attractor. Recently, such examples were reported, but they turned out to be transient chaotic set, but not a real attractors. In numerical experiments, it is very difficult to distinguish a chaotic attractor from a transient chaotic set, since the transient behavior, even with positive Lyapunov exponent, can persist for an arbitrary long time. However, reliable computation of trajectory by numerical procedure like Runge-Kutt method with double precision can be done only on a very short time interval. For example, for this parameter in the Lorentz model, we have the following situation. On this time interval, we have transient chaotic behavior with positive finite time Lyapunov exponent, and after that, trajectory starts tending to an equilibrium point very fast, and the Lyapunov exponent is negative here. Reliable interval of computation here in this paper estimated as follows, and for a longer time interval in this paper it is reported that it's necessary to use one of the very powerful supercomputer for about 1 week. The difficulties of reliable computation can be demonstrated by the example of numerical analysis of unstable periodic orbits embedded into attractor and their characteristics. If they start straightforward computation from an initial point on unstable periodic orbit, then a numerical trajectory soon visualizes the Lorentz attractor. See this blue trajectory. However, if we will use the Pyragos stabilization technique, then numerical trajectory visualizes the real periodic orbit. See this red trajectory. This experiment demonstrates difficulties in reliable computation of the Lyapunov exponents and the Lyapunov dimension. Here, these characteristics are significantly different for two obtained trajectories computed from the same initial data. Thus, there are demonstrated finite time schedulability and difficulties of applying ergodic theory for the Lorentz system. It is interesting that while in this case we don't have uniform behavior of Lyapunov exponents and Lyapunov dimension for all initial points on the attractor, still we can apply analytical method developed by Gennady Leonov to obtain the exact upper bound of the Lyapunov dimension for all points in the phase space. While the possible existence of hidden attractors in the classical Lorentz model is still an open problem, hidden attractors can be found in various modifications of the classical Lorentz model. We have found a hidden attractor in the Gluchovsky-Dolzhansky model, which describes the convective fluid motion. In this situation, we have additional term to the classical Lorentz model, and for these parameters, we have the following behavior in the phase space. Here, separatrices of unstable zero equilibrium tend to symmetric stable equilibrium points, but still in the phase space we have a locally attractive set which is a hidden attractor with blue domain. Also, hidden attractors can be found in the Rabinovich model describing interactions between waves in plasma. Here we also have the same additional term, but the parameter A is negative, and similar situation in the phase space. Trajectories from the vicinity of unstable zero equilibrium point tend to symmetric stable equilibria, but still in the phase space we have a local attractor with green set. One of the effective methods for the localization of hidden attractors is the continuation procedure. In this procedure, we consider a parameter natural or inserted artificially into the system and organize its changing in such a way that for the initial value of parameter, we find an attractor in the model analytically or numerically. Often we have self-excitation of a non-trivial attractor. And then we consider the transformation of this attractor numerically while changing the parameter. In this procedure, at each step, we have an initial point which is close to an attractor and far from the equilibria. Thus, if the numerical procedure is stable, that is, initial data at each step is in the vicinity of an attractor, then we can find a hidden attractor which is not connected with equilibria. In this figure, we connected Glukhovsky-Dolzhansky hidden attractor with hidden transient set in the Lorentz model and hidden attractor in the Rabinovich system. Now, let us discuss hidden attractors in connection with well-known theoretical and engineering problems. First, let us consider the famous 16th Gilbert problem. In 1900, David Gilbert formulated a problem on the number and mutual disposition of limit cycles in two-dimensional polynomial systems. The problem is still unsolved even for quadratic polynomials and has a dramatic history. Up to now, the best results are the following. The maximum number of limit cycles in a quadratic system is 4, and in general, the number of limit cycles is finite. First non-trivial result was obtained by Bautin. He developed the ideas of Andronov and constructed analytically 3 limit cycles nested around one equilibrium point. He used the bifurcation technique and small parameters. Thus, these limit cycles are difficult to visualize numerically because of very small amplitudes. Later, Petrovsky, who was at that time the rector of Moscow State University, and Landis proved that the maximum number of limit cycles is 3. However, soon Petrovsky found a gap in his proof, and the rest of his life he tried to fill this gap. But soon it turned out that this is impossible. Almost at the same time, two groups in China found configuration with 4 limit cycles. 3 limit cycles with small amplitude constructed analytically by Bautin techniques around one equilibrium point, and additional normal amplitude limit cycle was constructed numerically around another equilibrium. The last interesting result was obtained by Ilyushenko. He proved the finiteness of limit cycles in such polynomial models. Remark that numerical search of limit cycles turned out to be a challenging problem, which is very well demonstrated by very interesting experiment of academician Kolmogorov. He distributed several hundreds of quadratic systems with randomly chosen parameter among students of Moscow State University and asked students to find the number of limit cycles. The result of this experiment was absolutely unexpected. Not a single field has a limit cycle. Remark that at that time it was known that the domain of parameters in your phase space corresponding to the existence of limit cycles is of full measure. Remark that self-excited limit cycles can be easily revealed in numerical experiments, while the computation of the inner nested limit cycles, which are hidden attractors, can be complicated. We developed a special analytical numerical procedure which allow us to visualize all four limit cycles in quadratic model. In this example, we have one limit cycle around this unstable equilibrium, and this attractor is self-excited, and around zero equilibrium we have three nested limit cycles. Equilibrium is stable, and this green limit cycle is also stable. That means that this is a hidden attractor. Now let us consider the famous Sommerfeld effect. In 1902, famous German scientist Arnold Sommerfeld observed in a physical experiment that a machine set on a poor foundation achieved only one-third of its effective level, while the most of the energy transferred to the foundation and its vibration. For example, here one can imagine the start of engine of a submarine in the water, when instead of high speed of the rotor rotation, the submarine starts to move from side to side. From a mathematical point of view, the Sommerfeld effect corresponds to the existence of two hidden attractors in the phase space of the model without equilibria. Since the model doesn't have any equilibria, here all attractors are hidden according to the definition. In physical experiments, the hidden oscillating regime with Sommerfeld effect can be easily seen. Since in the normal situation, the model starts from zero initial state, and when the state is attracted to the lower limit cycle with large amplitude and low velocity, while the desired working regime corresponds to the upper limit cycle with small amplitude and large velocity. Here, an engineering problem to put the initial state of the model in the basin of attraction of this upper limit cycle. Similar effect can be found in drilling systems. We consider a mathematical model of drilling system derived in Eindhoven University of Technology, and also found here hidden oscillations. The situation is the following. If we first switch on the power and starts the rotation, and when at friction, when our state of the system tends to the stable equilibrium point. If we first add the friction, and when switch on the power and start the rotation, then our system can experience vibration, which are hidden because the unique equilibrium point here is stable. Also, hidden oscillations connected with famous Kalman conjecture on absolute stability of control systems. Following the ideas of Vyshnyagradsky, Kalman suggested the following criteria of global stability of nonlinear control system with one scalar nonlinearity from a linear sector. In his paper in 1957, Kalman wrote, If non-linearity is replaced by constant k corresponding to all possible values of derivative of non-linearity, and it is found that the closed loop system is stable for all such k, that means that all such linear systems are asymptotically stable, then it is intuitively clear that the system must be monostable. That is, all transient solutions will converge to a unique stable critical point. Another reason of this conjecture was that if we will apply the method of describing function widely used for the study of oscillations, then it gives no periodic solutions under the conditions of Kalman conjecture. It is very interesting that Kalman had fantastic engineering intuition, and the statement is valid for the models in three-dimensional space, which our mind can easily imagine. But in four-dimensional space, this conjecture is not valid, and it's possible to find a configuration with non-trivial hidden attractor which coexist with unique stable equilibrium point. We developed a special analytical numerical procedure which allow us to construct a series of counterexamples to the Kalman conjecture. One interesting counterexample to the Kalman conjecture we found in the famous Keldysh model of flutter suppression. In 1944, Mstislav Keldysh, who later became the president of the Russian Academy of Science, studied a nonlinear model of flutter suppression for aircraft's control systems. At that time, the only general method available for Keldysh to study stability and oscillations in discontinuous model was the harmonic balance, and Keldysh used it. But note in his paper that his analysis is not rigorous. Recently, we found parameters in the Keldysh model corresponding to the existence of hidden attractors. Here, for this model, the sector of linear stability in the Kalman conjecture is infinite, and for our parameters we have the following situation. In the phase space, for the signum non-linearity, we have a hidden limit cycle, which coexists with a chaotic self-excited attractor, which is self-excited with respect to the ends of this rest segment. But if we will consider definition in the definition of discontinuous model in the sense of Iserman and Piatinsky, and we'll consider smooth approximation of the model, for example, instead of signal, we will consider hyperbolic tangents, when in the phase space we will have coexistence of periodic hidden attractor, chaotic hidden attractor, and locally stable equilibrium point. In general, there is no straightforward procedure for revealing of all possible hidden oscillations, and they can lead to accidents. After one of such corresponding accidents of American firefighter F-22, Ladwell, Murray, and Forsin in your paper wrote the following. Since stability in simulation doesn't imply stability of a physical control system, an example is the crash of F-22 in 1992. Stronger theoretical understanding is required. The classification of attractors as being self-excited or hidden was introduced in 2009 by Gennady Leonov and me in connection with the discovery of the first hidden Chua attractors. In 1983, famous scientist Leon Chua invented a simple electronic circuit which can generate chaos. For various circuits parameters, he switched on the system and observed how the circuit state tends to a chaotic attractor. Since his experiments started from zero initial state, Leontieva conjectured that if the zero equilibrium is stable, then there are no chaotic attractors in your model. Since that time, more than 10,000 papers have been published in which hundreds of different Chua attractors have been found, and all of them, until recently, were self-excited. In 2009, working on the Kalman conjecture and developing the harmonic balance method, we found a first hidden Chua attractor. We consider such circuit parameters that the zero equilibrium is stable and trajectories from the vicinity of symmetric saddle stationary points tends to infinity or to a stable zero equilibrium, but still in the phase space there are two symmetric hidden attractors coexisting in the model. To visualize hidden attractors existing somewhere in the phase space, we need to be able to choose initial data in your basin of attraction. And of course, we cannot rely on random choice of initial points for research of attractors, especially in multidimensional dynamical models. For the search of hidden attractors in the Chua model, we modified the classical harmonic balance method. This allow us to get an initial point in the vicinity of a periodic attractor for the Chua model with small parameters, and then we used the numerical continuation procedure. Here you can see the application of the above analytical numerical procedure for the localization of hidden Chua attractors. For very small parameters, we get an initial data in vicinity of periodic oscillation and computed. When at each step we take initial data on the oscillation, slightly increase the parameter and observe transformation of this attractor. At the last step for epsilon equal 1, that is for the classical Chua model, we get two symmetric attractors which are hidden since they cannot be computed from vicinities of equilibria. We presented our results on hidden attractors in Chua circuits to Leon Chua in 2012, and Leon was very amused that after so many years of studying of his model, new uncovered attractors have been found. He expressed a conjecture that the birth of hidden attractors in his model is connected with subcritical Andronov-Hopp bifurcation and asked us about possible number of hidden attractors in his model. A few years later, we visited Leon Chua in Dresden to prepare and discuss joint papers in which we described the configuration with five coexisting attractors in the Chua model. Now it's the maximum known number of coexisting attractors in his model. In this configuration, there is one large hidden periodic attractor coexists with two symmetric chaotic hidden attractors and two trivial attractors stable equilibria. The picture from this paper was chosen for the cover page of the Journal of Bifurcation and Haus. And recently, with the help of the group from Saratov, Natalia Stankevich and Professor Selezniov, we reproduce this configuration of hidden attractors in real physical experiment. I very like this photo of Gennady, Leon and me because this was the last visit abroad for Gennady. As a conclusion, I would like to say that boundaries of the global stability in the phase space of parameters defined by the local bifurcations and the birth of self-excited and hidden oscillations in the vicinity of equilibria. And here we can recall 16 Hilbert problem and Chua conjecture. And by non-local global bifurcations and the birth of hidden oscillations. Here we also can recall 16 Hilbert problem, which is still unsolved in general case. Especially from the practical point of view, it is important to study practical boundary of the global stability, which corresponds to the birth of attractors. Localization of hidden attractors can be done via the expansion of the space of parameters and synthesis of the scenarios of the birth of oscillations, special modification of harmonic balance method, perpetuum points, and some other analytical and numerical tools. So here you can see the list of some publications and surveys on this topic. Thank you very much for your attention.